Hi, I'm Peter Nielsen from Sail Magazine. I'm here at the Annapolis Sailboat Show, October 2016, on board the Balance 526, which is one of the contenders in our Best Boats Awards. This boat is built in South Africa. So the Balance 526 was conceived as a blue water cruising catamaran designed to be easily and safely handled by a couple, which is the way most of these boats are sailed these days. Performance was pretty much key in the minds of the designers. It was designed by Phil Berman and Antoine Dutoit, and built by Jonathan Parman in South Africa. It's very nicely constructed. Build is core cell laminated between fiberglass and epoxy skins. You can see the design of the axe bows there is very contemporary, semi-wave piercing bows. The hulls are slim, but amply wide enough to provide some decent accommodations down below, as we'll see. On deck, this is a pretty standard rig configuration. There's a solent jib. This one's on a Reckman furler, which is a very nice piece of gear. So you just press a button, get rid of that sail. And outside it is set a screecher for downwind work and light airs. The jib is self-tacking, which makes life very easy. You can see the sail, the halyards are handled by this winch here. All the rest of the lines go back to the wheel in the cockpit, the helm station there. Right there, you can see the cabin top is like a sunbathing special, really. It's massive, and there's room for probably several kilowatts worth of solar panels on here. So this cat has dagger boards, although you wouldn't believe it from looking at the deck, because they don't actually protrude through the deck like most dagger boards do on performance catamarans. They stop just below deck level, and you can see here these two lines, one to pull the board up and one to pull it down, go back to clutches and a winch in the cockpit. So this particular boat also has a Reckman boom furler installed. This one's hydraulic. Boom furlers are still unusual on cruising catamarans, but I'm sure they're going to become more common over the coming years. Okay, so here we are at the helm station. All the sheets are led aft to these clutches here. Two big Harkin winches to control them. They're both electric, controlled with your toes, as is common on catamarans. Down here we have the controls for the headsail and mainsail furlers. Little instrument repeater here and throttles. So this is pretty standard fare, but this cat has a little trick up its sleeve. Okay, so this cat has what Multihull company founder Phil Berman calls the Versa helm. It's quite a clever system, and I haven't seen it on a catamaran before. So what we do is we slide the floor back, we step down here, we pull this pin out, and the helm station slides down, folds down rather than the pedestal, and you're in a completely protected steering position here with almost panoramic visibility. So when the weather's really bad and you don't want to sit up there, or you're getting too sunburned up there, you can steer from down here quite happily. The chart plot is right here. Engine controls are duplicated between the two helm stations. It's quite a clever system. Okay, so we're inside the saloon, which is nicely proportioned, and as you can see from these windows, beautifully lit. We are at the nav station here, which is not a traditional nav station. There are no instruments, but you can run the boat from a tablet these days, cooked up to your electronics, so there's no real reason to have anything else down here. There's a beautiful, nice L-shaped settee. These two tables drop, so you can form an extra berth here. The galley and is very nice. This particular boat has twin fridge and freezers. It's a beautiful panoramic view out of these doors. You can see there's almost a seamless transition. There's a slight lip there on the door to keep water out if there's following sea of the saloon, and a lovely U-shaped galley, which will be just perfect. So weight saving was paramount when this boat was designed and built. All the interior furniture, the bulkheads and everything like that, everything structural is cored, including this table leaves, which looks like a beautiful solid wooden table, but it's actually very light indeed. It's almost feather light. Even the sliding doors here were made by the builder in composite, just to keep weight down over the usual metal sliding doors that are constructed for boats such as this. So there's a lot of thought gone in. The flooring is all lightweight. The false teak in the cockpit is much lighter. So I'm down in the starboard hull, which is the owner's suite. You'll note that these steps are quite unusual because of the angle of the hull, the width of the saloon, and the narrowness of the hulls. These are quite steep, so they've been cut away. So you just walk down them step style rather than as the usual kind of companionway stairs. So here we are in the owner's stateroom, which is almost a mirror image of the stateroom in the other hull. You'll see there's a queen size bed here, plenty of headroom above it, good ventilation, lovely soft mattress. And in here we have a very clever idea, which is forced ventilation. So when you're at anchor, you drop these open and the breeze will blow through the boat and into your cabin here. So there you have it, another hot entry into a pretty competitive market, which is getting more competitive by the year. I think the market for these fast cruising cats is only going to grow, and this boat sets the bar pretty high.